Welcome to the Xfinity Center at the University of Maryland as the Terrapins take on the Westchester Golden Rams in both teams' first meet of the 2024 season. Alongside Christina Chauvinet, my name is Jack Bowman, and we welcome you to this broadcast of NCAA Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus. Both of these teams coming off of some of their best seasons ever. Maryland finishing last season ranked 23rd and Westchester finishing 60th. Tell me a little bit about what we can look to see from Maryland in their first meet of this season this evening.
You know, Maryland did lose some key routines, like Chickneas, Alexis Rubio, some other routines, but they are returning some powerhouses. Emma Silverman coming back as a graduate student, super excited to see her in her all-around. Coach Brett Nelligan told me she looks better than she ever has. Natalie Martin coming in as a four-star ranked recruit as rated by College Gym News. Really exciting gymnastics across the board tonight.
As for Westchester, again mentioned, they had their highest final ranking in program history last year at 60th. What are you looking to see from them here?
Yeah, as you mentioned, remember, Westchester, one of those Division II teams, they do compete with the same rules that the Division I teams do, and that was really exciting for them. Qualified USAG Nationals for the second year in a row. They're looking to build on that. They've got some exciting upgrades they're debuting tonight, so looking forward to seeing that.
And as we get a look here at the rotation, Maryland going in Olympic order, and then for Westchester, they got bars, vault, floor, and beam. And before we get started here, we were talking a little bit right before about some rule changes and some scoring changes. Can you explain that for the audience?
Absolutely. So remember, every other year, there's a major code change to point back and things like this. This is an off year for that. So we didn't see value changes, but what we saw was a banding rule change. So on bars, beam, and vault, gymnasts have to hold their landing position for a full second with their arms up. Otherwise, they will get a half-tenth deduction. That was not in place in prior seasons. It's an effort to reduce what we call the college stick, that is turning to salute the judges really quick in case they're off balance. I'm really interested to see how the judges evaluate that tonight.
So as we see right here, Maryland starting on vault. Their competition order will go Taylor Reck, Olivia Weir, Josephine Cogler, Emma Silverman, Alexa Rothenbusher, and then Natalie Martin, the freshman, anchoring.
Absolutely, and the back end of that lineup, 4, 5, 6, all 10-0 start values. So that's something really exciting. Natalie Martin anchoring that as a freshman, big stuff.
And we do have two exhibitions as well for Maryland on vault. We've got Samantha Gilbert and Logan Buckman. And coming up first here from Maryland is going to be Taylor Reck. She'll get things started on the vault. And Taylor Reck, obviously, you know, looking to get a good start here at the beginning.
And she's going to be competing the Yurchenko full, very common vault that we see in college gymnastics. Starts from that 9.95, consistent athlete for Maryland last season. So what I'm looking for her, we're looking long vault, remember, keys are amplitude, distance, and landing. So getting that push off the table and get Maryland off to a good start here. Getting a look at Coach Brett Nelligan there. He's giving her the thumbs up.
And Reck, Maryland's number 5 returner on vault.
And came in just a little bit short there. I think our viewers might not have been able to catch that vault, but did do a full twist of Yurchenko. Came in a little shy, but minimized the hop forward on that landing.
And starting on the bars for Westchester, it's going to be Hyla Betts.
And this routine doesn't quite have the difficulty, as we'll see from some of the other Westchester athletes later in the lineup, but nice handstand on the low bar, toe shoot, keeping great rhythm through this routine. Gearing up, she's got a double layout dismount. Some shape issues in that second flip, but I really liked her swing on the bars, getting them off to a really solid start.
Yeah, that's what you're looking for from Betts there, a solid start. And up next on the vault from Maryland is going to be Olivia Weir.
And another one of those athletes doing the Yurchenko full.
Next up on the vault.
So first three athletes from Maryland doing that Yurchenko full. Next three athletes going to have some variety in the lineup. Just a Leo alert. Of course, Maryland loves to put the Maryland flag on all the Leos. We know Marylanders love their flags. Westchester has a new Leo tonight. Gymnast confirmed for me before, so College Gym News, if you're out there listening, hopefully this goes into the Leo rankings. I love the Westchester leotard, by the way.
You talked about the Maryland flag. I don't know if there's any state that puts their flags on more articles of clothing than Maryland does.
Absolutely love it, and when Brett Nelligan, head coach, very sensitive about that too. He says it's the best flag in the country, so... in that full, did not get the stick, but had a good lift off the table, and that's what we're looking for.
And a score update, Taylor Reck with a 9.525 to start off the vault. And coming up now on the bars for Westchester's Christina Rodriguez.
And Christina Rodriguez, just such a huge contributor for Westchester. We will see her in the all-around tonight.
And another score update, Hyla Betts starting off with a 9.725 on the bars for Westchester. And we're underway.
Doing that full turn into the pack salto. Nice swing there. Shy on that handstand on the low bar. Remember, we are looking for those handstands to go all the way up to vertical. And that is going to be a point of separation for the judges tonight. Borderline on that last handstand, I'd say a small deduction. Goes for that difficult full twisting double back. That's the landing position. Whether the gymnast sticks it or not, they do have to come back to the landing position and hold it for 1 second. Did a good job there. And Coach Mark reported that before the meet, told me that's something they've really been honing in on for preseason.
Next up on vault from Maryland, Josephine Kogler, a second team All Big Ten for beam last year.
Yeah, really known for her beam work, but has really nice lines on vault as well. Another really nice body line there. Gets good distance off the table. You know, when I talked to Brett Nelligan before the meet, he said, I'm anticipating we might not have as many sticks as we'd like because there is just so much adrenaline coming in, and that is a hard thing to come in. Your first home meet, this is packed with fans, and so that's okay, though. I think at this point in the season, getting those solid dynamics is really what they're looking for. She did a good job there.
Yeah, he did mention that, just kind of the excitement playing a factor. And again, another score update, Olivia Weir with a 9.725, second on vault for Maryland. Next up on the bars for Westchester is going to be Melina Ringas. And again, you talked about the pack stands here. The energy really good for the first meet of the season here at Xfinity.
Absolutely. There's a club gymnastics meet going on nearby and got the club kids over to join and so many fans in the house. So that's really great to see.
You can see them actually right across from us. That was pointed out to us as well.
And she's debuting a new release. She switched from the Jaeger to a Ginger. So I believe that's what we're going to see here. Just doing a few final cues to herself. I used to love to talk to myself when I was a gymnast. And here's that free hip. This is a difficult combo she's going for. You know, I thought she might have been a little close on that Ginger, but keeps the swing going. Some leg separation in that bail to handstand in those transitions, that is a place that the judges should be deducting. Oh, you know, I think she just came in, was going after that handstand a little too aggressively. And that is something, again, we're talking about the adrenaline. First meet, right? And I think she had a good routine going, probably was excited about debuting her new release. Congratulations to her. And just overcooked that handstand. Going after this dismount here. Double layout. The hop back. You know, too bad. Over that, you know, that is a fall, so that is a score they're gonna be looking to drop, but some good building blocks in there.
And they do have a little bit more room for that. Their second score, 9.675, and Kogler with a 9.775 for Maryland on their third vault. Next up is Emma Silberman.
And I love this vault. Her full on, pike off, step back, but you know, that is those 10-0 start values. She really had worked a couple years ago. They downgraded the tucked version of that vault, and so she had to relearn the pike. Last year was her first year doing the pike, and she told me that she'd really been working in off-season, getting a better block off the table. Really tricky when you're twisting onto the table to get that block, or that, remember, when we say block, what we mean is pushing away from that vaulting table so you can get that nice height. And she did a good job there.
And she is Maryland's number one returner on vault, so a really important piece this year.
And just absolutely, she's been so consistent for Maryland gymnastics, and excited to see her in the all-around tonight.
And up now on the bars for Westchester's Hannah Shelton.
And she's another one of the Westchester athletes doing one of those difficult single bar releases. We're going to see a Takacha in this routine. Say for the scores, the first couple scores that we've gotten, I'm surprised at the ordering of those. I would have had Rodriguez is higher than Betts, but I'm not at the judging table. I'm in the booth. So let's see, here it is right off the top. And some leg separation in that pack salto. Keeping nice rhythm through this routine. There have been places in this routine, including right there, that she was shy on handstand. And the handstands are, every handstand is a potential for a deduction. So that's an area for improvement, but got some great difficulty in there with the Takacha.
An update, Silberman with a 9.8 on her last routine, and now it's gonna be Alexa Rothenbusher here.
She's doing a super difficult vault, this soup full. Wow, that is one of the best vaults I've seen her do. Soup full, really tricky because you're not getting that round off onto the table to build your momentum. And that's one of the things that she's really been working on, is getting that block. And I thought she handled that really nicely. Only a few athletes in NCAA doing that soup full.
And up next on the bars is going to be Sarah Askew for Westchester.
And she's got really nice form on bars. She's another athlete that's going to be doing that finger release move, which is one of my favorite release moves to do. I could never do it, I should say, to do. It's one of my favorite release moves to watch in college gymnastics.
And you mentioned that with the fall, Ringus' score, one that they're trying to drop, comes out to a 9.075. So it's going to be important from here on out that they deliver good scores.
Yeah, remember, for folks new to college gymnastics, we're 6-up, 5-count.
And both teams will have 2 exhibitions after those 6 today.
Yeah, and so though those exhibitions are not scored, are not part of the team score, they are scored, so the athletes get to see what that would be scored should it be part of the counting lineup. But sometimes you see those exhibition athletes competing in exhibition break into the lineup. And here she's doing that difficult combo, the full turn into the ginger. Caught it a bit close, but keeps it moving. Nice pack salto. Shy on that handstand on the half turn. But again, keeping nice rhythm when after that final handstand. Nice double layout. I'm so impressed with the difficulty that Westchester is bringing. Again, like I mentioned, they're Division II. They're scored under the same rules as Division I, and they've got some great release work in their lineups.
And up next on the vault's going to be Natalie Martin closing it out for Maryland.
And this is a huge vault. Martin, this is a debut that a lot of college gymnastics fans have been excited about. That 1.5, of course, starting from the 10.0, difficult to get the landing because of that line landing. She got great dynamics. We're going to take a look here on replay. Nice block off the table, legs together, that little hop, but at this point in the season, don't really expect her to be sticking. That's the first time out for her, but did an absolutely great job on that first ball.
And such a big recruit from Maryland. You mentioned to me before the broadcast, a four-star recruit as rated by College Gym News. Just a really big get for the program.
Absolutely. And we're going to see her on three events. Tonight she is training doors as well. We will not see her on that tonight, but she's going to be a star for Maryland.
And up next on the bars is going to be Jordan Coleman for Westchester.
And I absolutely love to watch Jordan on this event. One of the best bar workers in Division II gymnastics, in my opinion. Just has a really powerful swing. We're going to see that right off the top. She's got a big straddle Jaeger. Transition, legs together in the overshoot, really, really clean. Does this free hip, nice handstand in the free hip. Full turn, double back. That's a way to put an exclamation mark on a rotation.
That's a pretty incredible finish for Westchester. This is a score update. You talked about a welcome to college gymnastics for Natalie Martin, scoring a 9.85 on her first vault. And up on exhibition, Samantha Gilbert from Maryland.
And she's doing that Yurchenko half. Great job on that landing. I think that was a pseudo stick, I would describe. Would not quite be in that stick category, but really good control on that landing. Some knee bend in the air, which is another thing we're going to be looking out for tonight. But overall, really nice job.
And a big pop from Westchester as the score was announced for Jordan Coleman. Hasn't popped up here on our...
And I saw one judge flip a 9.95, I believe. So let's look and see what it comes in at.
I got a pretty big reaction instantly from...
The Westchester crowd is hype, so apologies because I can't see the other judge. So we're going to wait to get that in.
I mean, just vision. It was incredible. I would not be surprised.
She's so... And this is...
It was a 9.925 is the final score there.
Division II gymnastics, folks. If you are not watching Division II gymnastics, you're missing out. They are so, so strong.
And really an incredible finish to the bars for Westchester.
And we've got an exhibition going on bars at the moment as well.
That's McCarthy Keene.
Oh, and just took a fall on her Jaeger. You know, and I think sometimes it can be difficult to go. You have such a huge huge reaction, you know, huge celebration for the team, and then you got to recenter yourself. But would just miss the release on her Jaeger, I think.
And you mentioned that sometimes exhibitions can end up scoring better than some of the competing athletes. We had Samantha Gilbert with a 9.725.
Yeah, you know, Taylor Reck at the start of the lineup, not quite as powerful as I'm used to seeing her. And so that is something that's really good for them to be able to prove themselves in that exhibition spot. And getting back underway here for Keene. Oh, good fight through that. Good for her. Nice fight to get back up, finish that routine. You know, had a little trouble in that full turn, but got that into the dismount nicely.
And next up for exhibition from Maryland is Logan Buckman on the vault.
Logan's one of their first years. That Yurchenko full. Nice and powerful. She had a pretty body line. Some pike at the end, but that's a really solid option for Maryland on vault.
And she's on eval now, and the final exhibition for Westchester is going to be Cara Vargo over on bars. And Logan Buckman finishing up with the last exhibition of the rotation for Maryland as they huddle over by the vault. And Vargo's going to take to the bars.
And I can unofficially confirm that Jordan Coleman just broke the Westchester record on uneven bars thanks to the balance beam situation for all of these records. Again, unofficial, cannot swear to it, but looks like she has broken the Westchester record. congratulations to her. Phenomenal routine.
What a way to start the season.
Did I tell you or did I tell you?
You told me.
She's one of the best bar workers in Division II gymnastics.
I'll give it to you. You called that one. And Logan Buckman with a 9.675 to finish off exhibitions from Maryland. And now we're just waiting for Cara Vargo over here on the bars.
It looks like there's a judging conference at the moment. When the judges have a separation, depends on what the group score is, but a big separation of scores, they have to come together. They're probably evaluating whether to give her credit on what she did after the fall and how she continued her routine afterwards.
McCarthy Keene, that is.
Yes, for Keene, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it looks like an 8-7 is on one of the judges' cards right here.
And, you know, this is a challenging position for an athlete when there is a judging conference or some other delay. You know, you're ready to go, you're hyped up, and then you have to kind of stand around.
Yeah.
And, you know, just trying. You can see she's just kind of doing some cues for herself there, trying to keep herself loose and stay in the moment.
I mean, rhythm's so important for any athlete. When you throw a wrench into that, it can really complicate things, especially in like a performance type sport where you are the only athlete competing in a given moment and all the pressure, all the eyes are on you. It's hard to interrupt that rhythm.
And Vargo, the transfer from Ball State here, doing that Maloney. Slight separation in the Maloney and Bale, but keeping nice rhythm. Shy on that handstand. I love the toe on handstand into the double back. Some places to clean up in that routine, but I really like the, when I say nice swing, what I mean is that the elements are connected to one another and it's not looking labored, and that's a really important element on bars.
And so that'll wrap up our last exhibition of the first rotation. Stay with us here on Big Ten Plus as we come back in just a few minutes for the second rotation. As we just finished up the first rotation, and what do you think about the performance from both sides?
Well, you know, for Westchester, I thought they demonstrated showed some new upgrades, had some nice difficulty. You got to talk about Jordan Coleman, that 9.925 Westchester record. Just huge gymnastics. And we're going to see her on vault. By the way, this is her vault debut. Learned this vault over the summer. Started training vault again, so I'm excited to see her there.
In the road, we can go over the order for both teams. So Maryland now on the bars and Westchester on the vault. From Maryland, it's going to be Tasha Brzezowski, Victoria Gatzendorfer, Sierra Kondo, Emma Silberman, Rhea LeBlanc, Haley Merchant, the transfer from NC State, Alexa Rothenbusher, and Gianna Ruffing. And then on Westchester's side, it's going to be Bridget Sullivan, Christina Rodriguez, Kareen Gruber, Jordan Coleman, Shannon Carroll, Sarah Askew, and Cara Vargo. For both teams, Rothenbusher and Ruffing are exhibitions from Maryland, and Vargo's an exhibition for Westchester.
Absolutely. And so we're just in the touch period here. And as we take a look at, again, seeing that Maryland bar there, and you see Brett Nelligan, he is the head coach, but he also is the lead coach for bars. Most of the coaches have an event that they specialize in for coaching. And I can't wait to see Haley Merchant's routine. You know, transfer from NC State, they totally redid her bar routine. And I'm going to give NCAA gym fans a sneak peek, if you haven't seen it on Twitter or Instagram yet, she's doing a Ray and a full twisting double layout. This is one of the most difficult bar routines in college gymnastics. Absolutely thrilled to see her do that here.
And you talked to me and coaching staff before the game about how big of an impact Merchant can have for this Maryland team. Talk a little bit more about that.
Yeah, I think that one of the routines that Maryland lost from the previous season is Aleha Chipnias, who was one of those athletes on bars that could break into the 9.9s. And so it's nice to have an athlete like Haley Merchant coming in that can really, in that anchor position, really go for broke. I think we could see her get into the 9.9s. And I think that they were really smart about the routine composition. Brett Nelligan told me she came in, she was competing in Maloney Pack Salto double layout, and she came in, said she wanted to do the full twisting double layout, that upgraded dismount. Remember, you don't get any extra credit, as it were, for doing the full twisting double layout, because a double layout already has the most difficult rating. I love when we see athletes that are just hungry to try and upgrade their routines. And so she came in, she wanted to do that, and Brett worked with her to figure out what were the elements, and she said she also wanted to train Array. And so they just played around, had fun over the summer, and Brett said everything looked so good, and actually doing the Ray, she has an overshoot connection now, kind of eliminates potential deduction on a half pure wet on the low bar. So I think it's a really smart routine composition, and that is really key. It's not only what the athletes can do, but also how are they putting together routines that are really highlighting their strengths. And look at Barbara Ford over there of Westchester.
And, you know, flipping over to Westchester, what are you looking for them on the vault?
So, for Westchester, one of the things that we're going to see here is how many of their vaults are they twisting? A lot. They have some vaults that I know they're working towards twists but are not quite ready yet, and we're going to see those Yurchenko layouts. And so the Yurchenko layout starts from a 9.75 as opposed to the twisting Yurchenko that starts at a 9.95. So really interested to see what mix they're going to have in there, because I know they have some of those athletes. Of course, Jordan Coleman going to debut on vault here, coming off her record-setting bar performance, but really looking for Christina Rodriguez. She's also training the laid-out Yurchenko full, but I believe we are going to see the tuck full here. That's out of a 9.9 start value.
And, you know, flipping back to Maryland with 45 seconds here left in the touch period. So other than Merchant, who, you know, we talked about, who else are you looking out for on the bars?
Well, this bar lineup is really strong top to bottom. You know, Sierra Condo, their top returner on bars from last season, she's just got a huge Jaeger. I always love to see that. Emma Silberman, really clean bar swinger, and has a really nice, powerful dismount as well. Victoria Gatzendorfer, I really enjoy. She's got great toe point. She does a stalter into her dismount, which I love to see. So really just top to bottom, it's exciting for me.
And we are transitioning here from the touch period into competition. Both teams getting ready. Touching back to that first rotation, I think that they did give the last exhibition, Cara Vargo, a 9.50. Just a little quick update there.
Starting on the vault for Westchester.
And so starting on the vault for Westchester is going to be Bridget Sullivan here right in front of us.
That I would like to see, and that's probably going to be an area of deduction, but I love the control she had on landing.
And again, the control evident the whole way through, and that's going to be a pretty solid start for Westchester. Is flipping over to the bar is going to be Tasha Brzezowski from Maryland.
Starting out on bars, your turn, Tasha Brzezowski.
And Brzezowski, the number four returner from Maryland on bars.
Started in an exhibition position, one of those athletes that over the course of the season kind of got into the lineup. I'm going to be really honed in on her first element as she gets into her release position, making sure that she's keeping that swing. And this is something that, by the way, Coach Brett Nelligan is known for. He likes to do, Simon Says, gymnastics with his athletes before they go on bars and really work through the whole routine. He told me, you know, that's something that he took from men's gymnastics. He was a collegiate gymnast at UMass, and goes through kind of the whole routine with his athletes just to make them feel good, give them some cues before they get started.
And we're about to get underway here as Bridget Sullivan ends up with a 9.50 to start vault for Westchester. And Brzezowski gets ready to start on the bars.
And remember that 9.5 is coming out of that 9.75 start value. So see here as she goes for a blind change clean. Really nice to see there. Good work into her Jaeger. Shy on her handstand there on the low bar. And a little shy on that final handstand as well.
Yeah, that one got a pretty big pop from Maryland as we go back to the vault, and it's going to be Christina Rodriguez for Westchester.
And again, I believe we're going to see the Yurchenko tub pull from her here. Yeah, nice position in that tuck. I really liked the positioning she kept throughout that ball. Almost looked like she was trying to open up for the stick because she came in a little shy, had to take that step forward. But keep an eye out for that because we will likely see that as a layout full later in the season.
An early season, all about development, working towards, you know, later in the season. That's going to be Victoria Gatzendorfer from Maryland over on the bars. And as you said, you can see again that Simon Says Gymnastics before Gatzendorfer starts her routine.
And Brett knows that I make fun of him about this, as many people do. But that's his routine that that he likes doing. The gymnasts enjoy like it as well. It's what they're used to. So.
Next on the bar, Victoria Gatzendorfer.
Places in Victoria's routine we're going to keep an eye out is she does this Maloney pack salto combination. Really important for her to keep her legs together on both of these skills. There's the Maloney. Nice job there. Some leg separation in the pack salto to clean on that Maloney. Good fight. She really had to muscle up that half pirouette, but gets around. Stalter into the double back. Doesn't quite stick it. I've seen her be cleaner. Obviously had that hiccup on the half pirouette, but her stalter work is really nice. A lot of gymnasts, you don't see that very often, and it's difficult to kind of get that around in combination.
And up now is Corrine Gruber for Westchester. And a quick score update, Tasha Brzezowski with a 9.8.
In that layout. Again, I'm really impressed with these Westchester athletes. They're holding that finish position, not giving the judges anything away, but I think that body position looks like that is a potentially upgradable vault because she kept her hips pretty open in that position.
And again, I was saying before, Christina Rodriguez with a 9.70 on the second vault for Westchester, and back to the first bars routine from Marilyn Brzezowski with a 9.80.
Yeah, Brzezowski got them off to a good start. I will say, Gatzendorfer, we're going to see a much lower score. That's not going to be a score that they want to keep. So some pressure on Sierra Kondo here, but she's dynamite on this event.
And again, I know we've discussed on the last two, it is really interesting to watch the going through the full routine before they start.
Yep. Yeah, exactly. And just like kind of get those mental cues so that they can feel really confident and prepared.
So Sierra Kondo up now on the bars.
That I think is the gold standard in NCAA gymnastics. So we'll take a look here.
And Kondo, Maryland's top returner on the bars.
It's coming in. Big air time. And you know, she caught a little awkwardly, I thought, on the low bar, but she keeps it moving. She's a seasoned athlete. Double layout, didn't quite get the stick, but again, at this point in the season, neither one of these teams had a meet last week, so this is the first meet for both of these teams.
And back to vault, Jordan Coleman, as you said, off her record-setting performance.
And I believe we're going to see a layout for her as well. Yeah, you know, she was off directionally. You see those lines there. In college gymnastics, those lines are there for guidance. Unlike floor, there is not a mandated amount of deduction associated with where those lines are, which I would like to see that in the code, because I think if we're going to have the lines there, there should be what I call a neutral deduction, what the sport calls a neutral deduction associated with that, but that's not the way the scoring is now. But Coleman, you know, she's really known for her bars work and floor, and she actually works at a gym, and I believe over the summer, a gymnastics gym, I mean, Barbara Cordova, head coach, told me over the summer, she went in and started just playing around on vault, and here she is in the vault lineup, so great to see athletes adding events.
Back to bars, next up from Maryland is Emma Silberman.
And I mean, I can't say enough good things about this athlete. She really, you know, talked to Brett Nelligan before the meet, says she's looking better than she ever did. She did have, a few years ago in her career, she had an Achilles injury that she came back from, got back last year, was competing all around. Brett Nelligan told me he thinks she looks even better now than she did last season, and she had a great season last season.
Yeah, and you talk about that great season. She's Maryland's top returner on floor and vault, number two on the bars, as we're about to see, and number three on beam.
Yeah, you know, she is an all-arounder. She really is very even across the four events.
And Coleman with a 9.475 on vault.
Maybe just rush to that first handstand a bit, but nice thing. Oh, goodness. Again, I think that this, we saw an athlete from Westchester make the same mistake, just a little bit overexcited coming into that handstand, going a little too hard for it. Oh, and gosh. Does it again. Uncharacteristic for her, for sure.
Now, how hard is it to refocus in moments like this where you've kind of got to reset?
Yeah, I mean, it's incredibly difficult. And we do also have a vault underway here.
And that was Shannon Carroll going at. Maybe a little bit of miscommunication went while the bars routine was still ongoing. But
Silberman, though, nice job finishing out that routine. She'll shake that off. Just, you know, it's the first meet. But, yeah, it is really difficult. To your original question, it is really difficult to come back, especially on bars, because every skill is building on the other. So to get that back on, you know, she really just had her dismount at that point. And catching the vault on replay here.
And again, not really sure if there was some kind of miscommunication. Again, went while the bars routine for Emma Silberman was still underway.
Yeah.
So I guess we'll probably move on to Rhea LeBlanc now on the bars from Maryland.
Yeah, it does look like there might have been some miscommunication when Emma had that ball.
And as you said, Emma Silberman just too good and too experienced to let that, you know, shake her in any kind of long-term way, but it is hard in the moment when you lose that momentum that you've been building throughout the
Absolutely.
Routine.
Absolutely. You know, and remember, for college gym fans, when we talk about qualifying for postseason, you're counting six scores towards your national qualifying score. So you're counting just under, you're counting about half of your meets for the season. It's, most teams don't end up counting their first meet towards their national qualifying score. Remember, records do not matter in college gymnastics. It's all about the score. So, you know, that's something that I'm sure we're going to see her shake off in future weeks.
It's the final score for Silberman with the fall is going to end up at 9-0. Rhea LeBlanc on the bars now from Maryland.
A nice Jaeger. I would have liked to see a bit more amplitude, but keeps the swing going nicely. This routine critical, obviously, after a fall. As that little baby bounce in place, that's going to be a half a 10. But really nice to get them back on the right track there.
Yeah, and as you said, that score is so important coming after the fall. And back to the vault, Sarah Eskew. And Westchester coming off of a 9.2 from Shannon Carroll. maybe a score they'd like to drop after this one.
And so she does, comes up a bit short there, but she does the same type of vault that Emma Silverman does, that full-on, she does the tough version of that vault. So that vault starts out of a 9.95. I know she's also working on the pipe, but that isn't, she struggled with getting the amplitude off the table, and that is an area, that vault is really tricky. So I have seen her do that a bit cleaner, but I'm sure that's something she's going to be working on as she moves later in the season.
And so next up on the bar is the anticipated Maryland debut of Haley Merchant.
Yeah, really, like I said, I am so excited to see this routine really demonstrate the level of college gymnastics. So, so difficult. And Coach Brett Nelligan said, you know, she's fit in so great at Maryland. She said, he told me she's also, he said, yeah, she's a great bar worker, but she's also just a really good teammate, and he really, really values how she's come in and had that immediate impact on the team.
It's interesting, across, you know, the landscape of college sports with, you know, changing transfer rules, how important they've been to recruiting, to building team culture, not required, you know, sit out that year anymore. They can make an immediate impact.
Absolutely.
Such an important part of any team's recruiting plan.
Okay, everyone, hold on to your hats. This is a jam-packed routine right here. Goes for this toe on. Now here she goes, Ray. Oh my gosh. I think I jinxed her. She goes for the Ray, was off coming out of that. I think she caught her Ray a little bit close. Good for her. Goodness gracious. Good for her for going. I was wondering if she was going to go for that full twisting double layout given what happened earlier. That just shows you what kind of athlete she is. Just a little bit off of the catch of that rave.
And up on vault on exhibitions, Kara Varga.
And look, she's really happy about that landing there. Twisting vault in exhibition. So I'm kind of wondering, you know, we see the knee brace there, so might just have not been sure of how ready she was, but that's a vault that can contribute to the Westchester lineup. And, you know, if I were a betting woman, I would say a month from now we're going to see her in that lineup.
And just a score update while Haley Merchant is still on eval. Rhea LeBlanc with a 9.8, LeBlanc again, excuse me, with a 9.875.
Yeah, that's a little bit high to me. I would have had that a bit lower, but still really, really solid routine for them to get back on track. Not going to be the total that they were looking for, obviously, but, you know, now it's just regrouping. They've got to, and that's the thing about exhibitions. Exhibitions can also, when you have folks in these exhibition spots, that can turn around the momentum too after a fault, even though it doesn't technically count towards the team score.
Speaking of exhibitions, Alexa Rothenbusher up now from Maryland.
And I'm excited to see her on this event because she hasn't typically done bars for Maryland, really a power athlete contributing on vault and floor, but has been working bars over the summer. And I got a sneak peek when I went to visit Maryland practice over the summer. She's got a big dismount. She's looking really good.
You're not to ask you to project too much, but with Haley Merchant's routine, where do you think that score ends up?
Yeah, you know, that's, you're putting me on the spot here with my napkin maps. I mean, she caught pretty close on that Ray, and then she caught the overshoot kind of on her ribs. So I think, you know, they're going to have to take for the catch. They're going to have to take. Let's wait and see what they have on eval. Let me put it that way. It's hard for me to know where the judges are at.
She's asking you to do a lot of math on the spot.
Yeah.
And yeah, Merchant still on eval. That score still not available, but we do have Kara Vargo's 9.425 in an exhibition.
I anticipate it's going to come in higher than Silverman's. Let me put it that way. Silverman got a 9 because she had those two overarched handstands, right? So, like, yeah, it's coming in. I saw 1.955. I almost said 9.5, but then I was like, I don't want to go on record, and looks like I was about right. So, you know, I think, I mean, honestly, Merchant did a great job to keep that routine going. I think it was, she really caught that on the low bar, I thought she'd come off the bar, but that just shows you what a tough athlete she is, and they're going to count that score.
I mean, the persistence, obviously that implies, you know, mental persistence, but also just physically being able to hold on in that position.
Yeah, I mean, these athletes, they're incredible.
And it is a 9.425 from Merchants. So that's going to be the final, so it is going to be Silverman's that gets dropped.
If they want to rest an athlete for a week, if somebody gets injured, all of those things, it's nice to have those routines out there and have them score and have the athletes feeling confident if they need to come into a position.
And then we talked about that before the broadcast, that even though they don't contribute to a seam score, those exhibitions can be really important and valuable. Mm-hmm. And again, speaking of, one more coming up from Maryland, Gianna Ruffing. Westchester's all done on the vault, but Maryland with two exhibitions today on bars.
Just so many things. I don't think there's any college gymnastics coach that'll tell you that they didn't have some adversity during the season, an injury, somebody sick, any of those type of things. They wanted to rest somebody, so having that depth is really important so that they can step in as they are needed throughout the season.
And as we just saw on camera, they're a pretty good group of fans here today for the first meet of the season, especially impressive considering Maryland not yet back in school, students not on campus. So, you know, getting this kind of attendance without any, you know, students on campus, really that population showing up, pretty impressive.
Yeah, and, you know, even the kids have got the Maryland flag on their leotard. So, as you mentioned, it runs deep here.
And I don't know a state that loves their flag more.
It's very true. Like I said, they really love it. They're very, very – I'm not from Maryland myself, so I don't have the same – it's a nice flag. Hopefully they'll invite me back to commentate a meet after.
Gets a little tiring once you went through elementary and middle school seeing it on dozens of pairs of socks as Gianna Ruffing's now up on the bars.
A little quick into that, into her release, but really nice. Pike Yeager, one of those D-rated releases. Shy on that handstand. A little bit. I think she mistimed the release. You saw her take that hop forward, but some really nice work in that routine and just does that really difficult Pike Yeager release move.
And on the last, Rothenbusher with a 9.825 on the bars in Maryland's first exhibition. As we look back on some of the highlights, back to Westchester's first vault.
Yeah, and these are, you know, as I mentioned, they had, that was Bridget Sullivan, I believe, that we just saw. This is Christina Rodriguez, that tucked full. Again, I think she just came in a little early for that landing, but going to check out that later in the season. And I think they had some good dynamics here in their vaults. You can see that they are working towards getting that height necessary for the twist, but I think it's a good decision at this point in the season. And I talked with Barbara Cordova, she said, I'm not going to push the difficulty in the first meet. We want to get them out there. We want to get them comfortable with it. So I think that it was a solid rotation for them.
They finished with 47.80 on the vault.
And saw Sarah Eskew's vault there, and as I mentioned, had some landing control issues, but I love that she's going for that difficult vault, and I anticipate we're going to see that improve as we move through the season.
And Gianna Ruffing finished with a 9.750, so two really strong exhibition scores on the bars for Maryland.
Yeah, it's, you know, I mean, I think bars is, they have a lot of depth on bars, and so it's great for them to be able to get those routines out there. Tasha Brzezowski just nailed that double layout. Going to look at Gatzendorfer. Beautiful Stalder work into that double back. Really nicely done. And the double layout there for Kondo. Just really clean work.
Michael North from wrestling.
And you mentioned that Silverman just overextending on the handstand.
Yeah. Yeah, and you know, like I said, I think that's a normal mistake to make at this point in the season. So, you know, no big deal there. But some real highlights in that routine as well, including that full twisting double layout from Haley Merchant. I know that isn't the way that she wanted that routine to go, but I know she's going to come back, and I'm sure we're going to see that hit later in the season.
And welcome back to Xfinity Center in College Park as we get ready for the third rotation here. Maryland's on the beam, and Westchester will be on the floor. For Maryland, Emma Silberman, Olivia Weir, Natalie Martin, Victoria Gatzendorfer, Madeline Komorowski, and Josephine Kogler make up the six. For Westchester, it's Shannon Carroll, Kareen Gruber, Lily McFarland, Christina Rodriguez, and Kylie Fred and Caroline Cascaden. What are you looking forward to from Maryland on the beam?
You know, for Maryland on beam, Maddie Komorowski is one of my favorite athletes to watch. She just has gorgeous form, great toe point, and, you know, also Gatzendorfer and Silverman are doing those triple series, gets them some bonus points, really fun to watch. This was Maryland's lowest ranked event statistically last season. They did struggle a little bit with consistency, but they've got some great routines throughout this lineup. And Josephine Kogler in that anchor spot just shows really great lines on beam as well.
And as for Westchester, what are you looking forward to on the floor?
You know, for Westchester, Caroline Cascaden has really nice performance quality, great dance. She has upgraded from a double back to a double pike in her routine. And also, Lily McFarlane upgraded. She turned her routine into a two-pass routine as opposed to a three-pass routine by upgrading some of her opening pass and her closing pass. I'll point that out for us as we get in, but I know they've made a lot of upgrades in the offseason, Westchester has, so I'm excited to see those.
So up first, or who's going to be up first in just a moment here from Maryland on the beam, is Emma Silberman, their third highest scoring returner for the beam.
This is a moment of adversity. Obviously, she's coming off of that fall on bars. Got to turn it around and really slow it down for beam. She is really capable on this event. Again, one of those athletes that is doing the triple series, that back handspring layout step out, compared to a lot of the series that we see in NCAA, which is the back handspring layout step out.
And so Silberman getting ready here right in front of us. And just looking ahead a little bit, first up on the floor for Westchester is going to be Shannon Carroll.
Yeah, and so for, you know, just a reminder for folks about the code, and we talk about these triple series, remember on beam, floor, and bars, you've got a base start value of 9.4 if you meet all of the requirements, which all these athletes do. Then you have to build your difficulty up to 10.0 by doing more difficult elements that are required. Those are those D and E elements, as well as doing elements in combination. That's another way to garner bonus. So when we talk about these triple series, the back handspring layout step out, that garners 3/10 of bonus compared to the single back handspring layout step out, which garners 1/10 of bonus. So that's a way that these athletes can really build their difficulty. Sign there, clean through that full turn. Here she's getting set for her triple series. Rock solid, absolutely no movement on that landing. Calm beam, which I really like. She takes her time with her elements and doesn't rush things. Gearing up for her dismount here. That 1.5. Some leg form in the air, bent her knees a little bit, but good for her to recover. Hit routine for her after her fall on bars.
Just about to say the same thing. A really strong recovery after, you know, the fall on bars just a moment ago, and Shannon Carroll now up on the floor for Westchester.
She's a powerful tumbler. back, but doesn't have a round off. Very impressive.
To the beam, Olivia Weir, after Emma Silverman started Maryland off with a 9.775.
So difficult. She's just a really aggressive worker. I love to see that.
And the first score that came out looked like for Shannon Carroll was a 9.55. Did not see the other judge, so we'll just wait for that score to update as Kareen Gruber takes the floor. That's a 9.625 for Shannon Carroll.
And
it's the freshman Natalie Martin on the beam after Olivia Weir with a really strong 9.8.
And good for her, because her front foot was off on that layout step out landing, but she finessed it. Smooth work in that cat leaping arena. And goes for that tricky switch split combination. She might have been a little under on the second switch split. And a half. Nice landing. And that's an interesting place. I'm wondering if she held that for a full second. And it's interesting because the atmosphere of college gymnastics, you're here at your first college gymnastics meet, it's hype in here. And it can be hard for these athletes when they finish a routine to want to hold it because their teammates are going crazy. They want it, you know, they've got that adrenaline.
Exactly. The instant reaction from your teammates when you kind of have to hold that back is hard to do, and it's going to be Lily McFarland up for Westchester on floor.
And she's another one of the athletes that upgraded from last season, turned her routine into a two-pass routine. Remember, you can do two or three passes in college gymnastics. You just have to build your difficulty. And she has some exciting tumbling that she's going to debut here, including a front through to a double back. And then she's going to close with a double pipe. And when I talked to Bar Cordova, the coach, head coach at Westchester, she said, you know, this routine just works a lot better for her. She is a flipper. You know, in gymnastics in general, people prefer flipping or they prefer twisting. And she's so powerful, she prefers those flipping. And this routine really sets her up for success because she's got those two double salto passes. She can build her difficulty through that.
And Natalie Martin on beam finished with a 9.85. Again, having a really good first collegiate meet.
Yeah, really solid score there. If the flag went up, because I thought she might have gone out of bounds on the line there. With power there. You know, she's such a powerful tumbler. I don't think either one of her landings is what I would describe as a controlled lunge, and that's what you have to do on floor to get no deduction. It needs to look as if you're taking the step because you want to, not because you have to. It's a good problem to have too much power, but really exciting to see her debut that new routine, and she really can put that double pike into the rafters.
And back to the beam, Victoria Gatzendorfer. And just a little update on the floor score is Corinne Gruber at a 9.725.
Position in those splits. Gosh, I love her toe point. great attention to detail in this routine. Just the dismount left. She does the gainer pike. That's that stick. That's going to be a big number. That's probably the best beam I've ever seen her do. Just so confident and crisp throughout that routine.
As you said, the stick at the end.
Yeah, a soft knee here or there, but really, you know, really calm, really confident work throughout that routine.
And so after Lily McFarland's 9.675, it's Christina Rodriguez on the floor.
And she's such a great performer on this event.
Madeline Komorowski up from Maryland. You talked about Gazendorf maybe getting that big score. 9.875 is the final for her.
So pretty, this mount. What I love about her work is look at the releve positions. Look at the toe point throughout this routine. Oh, gosh. And I jinxed her. I did pretty in the air. It was very pretty in the air, but just her hips got off. And obviously very little margin for error when you're on beam. You can see what I mean there, though. The aerial is really fluid beam work. Stretch. It's just gorgeous. Good rest of her routine. Way to work through it. You know, just not her day on that series.
Next up on floor for the Golden Friends, Kylie.
And so next on floor for Westchester is going to be Kylie Fred.
And Gatzenbrofer, by the way, tying her career high with that 9.875. So I thought it was the best beam I had seen her do, and I guess the judges agreed with me.
And not bad to tie a career high in the first meet of the season.
And by the way, this is a new Leo for Westchester. They are debuting their new leotard. So for our friends at College Gym News, that can make it its way into the rankings, hopefully. And I'm not certain what the delay in the judging here is. Because I think it would be a pretty straightforward routine to score, but.
Rodriguez's?
Yes.
Are you
Yeah, it seems to be at the table further from us. A little bit of confusion, maybe.
Dude, I'm not entirely certain if they're having a judges' conference or if there's just something wrong with the scoring. But, you know, stay tuned. Again, this is a challenging position to get in with, to get when you are in a position and all of a sudden the meat kind of grinds to a halt as they're having this judges' conference. Looks like we did have a score come through there for Rodriguez.
That's a 9.675 is the final decision. On the beam is Maryland's anchor, Josephine Kogler.
And, you know, coming off that fall, she's a great athlete to set Maryland back on the right track. Smooth work in that opening leap series. Another one doing that triple series. Handles that landing no problem. What I like about these series from Maryland is that they really position their torso and their chest so squarely over the beam, really setting themselves up for success in those elements. Gainer pipe. You can see the turf was soaked about that one.
Next on floor for Westchester, Caroline Cascade.
And a strong finish from Maryland as we come back to the floor for Caroline Cascade and anchoring for Westchester.
And she's so pretty to watch on this event. Again, upgraded for opening pass from a double back last year, upgraded that to the double pipe. Technically, they're the same valuation, but it is a more difficult body position, and I love to see athletes pushing for that, so that's really exciting.
Oh,
her double pipe, and her performance quality just plays with the crowd. Really, really fun routine.
And as we head back to the beam, worth noting, Josephine Kogler with a 9.925, which ties her career high. And Layla Hammer now up for exhibition.
And I'm excited to see Hammer on this event. She has a lot of potential, really pretty dancer. And does this front toss, big front toss. I love her chest position on landing. Goes for a difficult cat leap into the switch half. Struggle on that switch half. Clean connection in that switch split to split jump. Just a soft knee, I think, on that second, on the split jump. Onto that stick. Really nice routine. I think she's got a lot of potential. Just a couple of areas to clean up. And congratulations to Josephine Kogler. I mean, she's a stunning beam worker. Great to see her and Gatzenwerfer get those career highs.
And back on the floor, Bridget Sullivan on exhibition. As Caroline Kaskaden's final score is still in deliberation. And it's a 9.65. So after Layla Hammer's 9.675 exhibition, Lauren Brendlinger up on the beam.
Again, Maryland showing some depth options on beam, and we'll see. Particularly Hammer, I think, could break her way into the lineup, but really solid routine for Brendlinger as well.
And so that wraps up for rotation three. And again, we talked about it just a little bit there. What do you think about Maryland's beam work there through that rotation?
Yeah, you know, they were really solid from top to bottom. Had that hiccup from Kamarasi in that five spot, not something we typically see from her. Really impressed with how Josephine Kogler was able to come back, anchor them with that career high 9.925.
And on the other side, Westchester with their, you know, floor routines. What'd you think about those?
Yeah, I really enjoyed Westchester's work on floor. I think there's a couple of dance areas that they may need to clean up. Remember that dance is dancing the turns, the leaps, they're evaluated just as heavily as tumbling. So there's a couple of pieces here that I was loving to see. Their upgrades, they debuted Cascade, such a lovely performer. Lily McFarland, powerful, and Christina Rodriguez, solid for them as always.
And you see right here, after her score of 9.925, Josephine Kogler doing a little T-shirt toss, but that'll bring us to the end of the third rotation. Stick with us here on Big Ten Plus. In just a few minutes, we'll get ready for the fourth. And welcome back to Xfinity Center in College Park as we take a look back at some of the highlights that we just saw in Rotation 3.
Emma Silverman getting Maryland off to a solid start. Good to see her bounce back after that fall on bars. You know, really solid across the lineup here. Olivia Weir here taking a look at her dismount. And a little bit of adversity, uncharacteristic mistake from Kamarasi in that five spot, but it is 6-5 count. And the rest of the lineup did a great job, including Natalie Martin having a great night in her first meet in college gymnastics. Gatzendorfer, career high for her. You can see she was stoked about that one. And then Kogler here just demonstrating her trademark calm, cool, collected beam work. Ties her career high as well there, 9.925.
And on the floor for Westchester as well.
And getting a look at the Westchester beam warm-up here, you know, I was really impressed with them on floor. They debuted some upgrades here. This round-off double back, really nice height there. Rare to see out of just a round-off. And that front double pull there, nice handling of the landing, even though she was a little bit under-rotated, still managed to control it, which I really liked. And Lily McFarland, such a powerful tumbler. You know, if anything, had too much power on this, had a couple of uncontrolled landings, but I'm sure that's something she'll hone as the season wears on. So just a couple seconds left here in the touch warm-up, folks. And you can take a look at those scores. Maryland 146.775. Westchester moving to beam 144.875.
And as we move forward into the fourth rotation, first up on beam in just a moment for Westchester is going to be Natalie Marshall, followed by Sarah Eskew, Caroline Cascaden, Christina Rodriguez, Madison Whitaker, and Lily McFarland. They've also got exhibitions from Cara Vargo and Lydia Stoner. On Maryland side, it's going to be Taylor Reck and Emma Silberman, Rhea LeBlanc, Madeline Komorowski, Alexa Rothenbusher, and then Natalie Martin. And in exhibition will be Shani Sirota.
And interesting because both of these teams are ending on their highest ranked event from last season. You know, for Maryland, they did lose Reese McClure, who was a huge contributor on this event, but they're adding in Natalie Martin. She's going to be in that anchor position. She's got a huge full twisting double back that I'm really excited to see. Kamarasi, you know, she's going to have to come back from her beam fall, but she's such a beautiful performer here. For Westchester, I really love to watch Christina Rodriguez on this event. She has really pretty lines and a unique dismount that we're going to take a look at in a little bit here. And also Lily McFarland, she's a super confident beam worker and displays that really powerful beam style.
Starting off on beam for Westchester. And so first up on beam for Westchester, it's going to be Natalie Marshall.
Thank you.
switch the straddle corner there. Nice start. Good control of that landing and that back handspring layout step out. I love how confident she is in her landings. I would have liked to see some better positionality in that cat leap, but connected it to the aerial well. Cool combo. That switch split into the gainer pipe. Of course, gainer pipe, very common. You see that a lot, but I love that combination, the dance into the dismount.
And with that, we kick over to floor as Taylor Reck is going to go first from Maryland.
And this is a fun routine. Good control in that front double hole. Drills that double back. So we'll see what the judges do with it. But what I liked about that is she really demonstrated complete control in those passes. No doubt that she was controlling the lunge she took out of it. Really nice work.
As we flip back to Beam and Sarah Eskew, following Natalie Marshall's 9.875 to open it up. And just a quick note on the beam before Kogler tying the second highest score in Maryland gymnastics history on the beam.
Marshall in that opening spot was so confident, so nice to see her rewarded there. Nice correction for Eskew on that back handspring layout step out. Again, just had that leg lift, but she took her time and was patient with it. Most of that difficult switch half. Shy of split in that, but connects it to the beat jump well. What I like about this routine is I can tell she's not having her best day on beam. Just like there, she took a little step, but she really fought through it. And that's what I love to see these athletes, you know, especially on beam. It's so easy to let a little mistake and you're on the floor. And she really took her time, was patient with those corrections. So good for her.
And back to floor from Maryland, Emma Silberman following Taylor Rex 9.85, opening it up.
Pass here. Rainy. think she had on bars really clean on beam and good floor work as well. She's so fun to watch on floor because she's having a blast out there.
Up now on the beam is Caroline Cascadon after Sarah Eskew scored a 9.60 on her go-around.
And she's such a fun beam worker. She does a standing layout step out in this routine, which is just so hard. Here it is, right here. And really great correction because she didn't quite get that fully rotated out of her front foot forward, but finesses that landing. As Maryland did, some really good control over their series. Shy of split position on that jump. Nice clean full turn there. That full turn is one of those requirements on beam. Rotated a smidge there on that dismount, but really great work. And again, for me, that standing layout step out, so difficult. Love to see that difficulty in college gymnastics. Again, folks, if you're not watching Division II gymnastics, you got to start watching it. I absolutely love the variety of skills we're seeing from Westchester tonight.
And so now up from Maryland on floor is Rhea LeBlanc. Emma Silberman coming off of a 9.75.
Yeah, you know, Silverman, I think in her first pass, she traveled a little bit coming out. She had that Bahraini into the straddle jump. Really what you want to see for complete control is that that straddle jump isn't traveling, and she showed a little lack of control there, so I think that might have been where the deduction came from, although we are now seeing a judges conference here as well. We had, now I'm seeing this on our Verdius platform, you can see the split of the judges, and I'm seeing here, judge one went 9-9, judge two went 9-6. So when there is a separation in the scores of that magnitude, they have to come together. I'm guessing it might have been over one of the dance elements. That was probably where there was some disagreement there, but when there is a split that's that large, they have to have a conference and decide what did you deduct, what did you not give that I did, and come to an agreement there. So great feature of this Verdius platform. You know, if you are a stat nerd and you want to follow along, you want to see are there neutral deductions, you want to see which judges are given what, you can check that out.
And definitely helpful in this case as we were able to get to the bottom of the judges conference. And looks like they've settled.
And certainly shouldn't be that big of a discretion. I wouldn't have gone as high as 9.9 for that routine, but I think I would have gone somewhere in the 9.75, 9.8 range.
And ended up adjusting it to a 9.8, because it's 9.9 and 9.7.
So judge two came up a 10th. They have to be within that 2/10 range. Just a little lack of control there on that front double full. There on that 1.5 front layout, good rise too. Yeah. of a landing correction on that first pass. Didn't quite get it all the way around, but solid routine for Maryland. A great final pass.
And as we flip back to the beam, it's Christina Rodriguez.
And Westchester is cruising on beam. Three really solid routines so far.
Obviously led off by Natalie Marshall's really strong 9.875.
Again, might have been the commentator, James, just saying how great they were doing on beam. Again, goes for that difficult switch half that is an E-rated dance element. And just not her day on beam, unfortunately. Check out this dismount, so cool. Front full, didn't quite get the stick, but really rare to see that in college gymnastics. And she's a really strong beam worker, again, just not her night, so too bad to see that. But I love that dismount, and I'm sure we'll see her improve on that in the season, which is fun.
And so after Raya LeBlanc ends up with a 9.825, it's gonna be Madeline Komorowski.
Going
to be Madison Whitaker. As you said, not Rodriguez's day. Finished with an 8.375.
Dismount left, she's doing a gainer pike. Holding it a little close to the beam there, but handles the landing. Good for them to get back on. It's a hit routine. A couple hiccups here and there, but still a solid routine for Russ Chester.
Again, as you said, good to get back on the right foot after a little bit of rough go with Rodriguez. As we get back to the floor, it's going to be Alexa Rothenbusher.
She's such a powerhouse on this event. Get ready. It's not Brittany. It's Alexa Rothenbusher. Double salto passes and really demonstrating her control there. You are certainly allowed to take the lunge back, but it's just like a little extra flex on the judges just to let them know, I don't even need to take this step, I got this.
And that one got a really big pop from the crowd here at Xfinity, and yeah. The last two floor routines been really strong for Maryland, 9.9 for Komorowski, and then Rothenbusher now on eval. And Whitaker still on eval for Westchester as Lily McFarland waits to take the anchor.
Lily McFarland, a great person to have in the anchor position for Westchester. Gearing up for her series right off the top here, backhand spring, layout step out. And again, her front foot was a little off, but she's up for the challenge. Such a strong beam worker. She's really confident, really composed on beam, and a great way to end that rotation.
And during that routine, you heard a, you know, pretty loud roar from the crowd. 9.925 from Rothenbusher, tying her career high on floor. And now it's Natalie Martin, the freshman.
And she's gonna tear the roof off this place with this opening pass. If she does what I believe she's planning, which is that full twisting double back. Huge. Out of the top. Rothel back on the double back, so I don't think we're going to see it match Rothelbusher. But again, welcome to college gymnastics. Natalie Martin, huge tumbling. Really, the sky's the limit for her potential here at Maryland.
Yeah, and that wraps up a pretty incredible first meet for Martin as back to the beam Cara Vargo on exhibition.
And this is an athlete I was excited. Check this. Oh, I wasn't sure if she was going to go for this combination. I have seen her connect the aerial to this back handspring layout step out. Wasn't quite on there, but potential for perhaps for later in the season. Off the end. Some great potential there. I think she just needs a little bit more time to work on some of those connections, clean up some pieces in that B routine, but she can get that aerial back handspring layout step out connected. That's a showstopper.
And one more floor coming up is Shani Sirota, who's going to be taking an exhibition from Maryland. And a 9.875 is the final score for Martin, so that wraps up the six from Maryland. Solid round of scores, a 9.850 from Reck, 9.80 from Silverman, 9.825 from LeBlanc, 9.9 from Komorowski, 0.925 that is from Rothenbusher, and then a 9.875 from Martin. Back to beam, we have the last routine of the evening is Lydia Stoner, exhibition for Westchester.
Nice front toss into that back handspring. Unusual series there. Shy of split there, but working through this routine really nicely overall. Really impressed with this front toss, really powerful. And we've seen several front tosses tonight, which is unusual because you don't see them that often in NCAA. One and a half. Oh, under rotates that, but gets it back together. I'm impressed with that because she still came back together to salute. So really nice job there.
And with that, the final rotation of the first meet of the season for both of these teams has come to an end. As you see right here, Maryland interacting with the crowd in front of them, coming to say hi to some of their fans. And we'll be right back here on Big Ten Plus to wrap up the evening.
Thank you.
And welcome back to NCAA Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus as we take a look at the final rotation, starting with Westchester on beam.
And this was Natalie Marshall. That dynamic 9.875, really beautiful to watch here. And Westchester across the board, really nice. Christina Rodriguez did have an off day for her, but otherwise really solid work across the lineup. Lily McFarland getting a look there, 9.875, another huge highlight. So I was really impressed with what they did on beam.
And now we get to take a look after this at Maryland's floor scores as they finished up their last rotation and really did a great job across the board on floor.
Yeah, you know what I liked that I saw from Maryland, getting a look at Taylor Reck here, who had one of the best floor routines I've seen her do, is the control that they had on landing. For the most part, those landings were really nicely controlled, and when there were mistakes, they dealt with them. And so really good starting pieces, just a few things here and there to clean up, but overall, great job.
Obviously the high scorer, the high point of that coming with Alexa Rothenbusher. You did call it again before she started, talking about how she was a force on floor and proved that with a 9.925.
And Komorowski, you just got to look at there. Such beautiful dance on floor. Rothenbusher, though, just showing off to the judges there with that double pike. Fantastic to watch. And Natalie Martin, you know, we talked about her all evening, really showing why she was such a highly touted recruit coming in for Maryland.
And she got a huge pop from the crowd as she finished her routine. Obviously, an awareness of how important she is to this program.
Absolutely.
Going forward. And so that wraps up the fourth rotation. As we look at the final scores, what do you see here? Like, what kind of trends do you see here that both teams might look to either fix, build on, you know, going into the rest of the season?
Yeah, so, you know, I think if we look at Westchester, 193.775, when you look at where they were last season, they didn't score in the 193s until their fifth meet. And so it's really great to see them come out here, get one of those really nice, they could count this number for their NQS. That's a usable score for them. They're really going to want to push into those 194s, but really strong performance from them overall. Maryland, you know, we saw some hiccups here or there. What I liked from them was that despite the hiccups from some of their standout performers, we saw the fall from Emma Silverman on bars, we saw the fall from Maddie Komorowski on beam, they rallied around. They didn't let that affect the overall tempo of the rotations. And 196, that's a really good starting point for them. They're going to want to push up to that 197 if they want to get a ranked position for regionals, but that's certainly a solid way to start the season.
And with that, we wrap up our first meet of the season. From me, Jack Bowman, and next to me, Chauvinet. And from everyone at Big Ten Plus, thank you for joining us this evening for NCAA Gymnastics, and we